Imagine it. A world where we have all the energy we need, more even, without any carbon emissions. A world where we can depend on having clean energy 24/7, not just when the wind blows or the sun shines. No pollution, no carbon emissions, and because the power plants are so small, barely even any impact on the land. If you're wondering what year we'll have this incredible technology by, the answer is 1957. Yeah, and we've been trying to kill it ever since. Nuclear energy, it's the power source of the future, and it has been for about 50 years. Back in 1967, it was predicted that America would have as many as 1,000 nuclear power plants online by the year 2000. Today, the actual number is 54. So, what happened? Well, just about the worst run of PR the world has ever seen. At least until Kanye. You've probably heard some of it. Nuclear power is blasting us with radiation. Nuclear waste is going to poison us all. Nuclear reactors could blow up like an atomic bomb. And to review, wrong, wrong, and wrong. In fact, when you look at the research, not only are most of the stereotypes about nuclear energy incorrect, they're pretty close to the opposite of the truth. Because as it turns out, nuclear power is just about the world's safest energy source. Now, we could dedicate a whole video to puncturing all of these myths, but we've done that already. If you want that story, you should click here. We think you'll like it. We're mean to the French for absolutely no reason. Anyway, when it comes to public attitudes on nuclear these days, something weird is happening. The fears seem to be fading. In 2025, 61% of Americans told Gallup that they support nuclear power, a number that's near an all-time high. What changed? Well, for one thing, we've learned that when it comes to carbon-free energy sources, nothing compares to nuclear. To give you an idea of what we mean, consider the following. American investments in renewable energy sources like wind and solar have looked like this over the past decade, reaching nearly $93 billion in 2023. Meanwhile, the number of nuclear reactors in America looks like this. They've been declining for over 30 years. And yet, despite those trends, nuclear power still provides more of America's electricity than wind and solar combined. In fact, while nuclear power plants make up just 0.4% of all the power plants in the U.S., they provide 18.6% of our electricity. And that's because nuclear power gets you incredible bang for the buck. For instance, the amount of energy nuclear can generate from a single uranium pellet that's only about an inch tall is as much as you'd get from 120 gallons of oil. Or 17,000 cubic feet of natural gas, or 1 ton of coal. All of which means that if you want a lot of power while still cutting carbon emissions, nuclear power is pretty much the only game in town. And here's the thing, we need a lot of power. The US Department of Energy estimates that the world is going to be using as much as 75% more electricity by the year 2050. One of the reasons? The massive energy demands of new technology, like AI. How massive? It's estimated that just one of the biggest new data centers would need twice as much electricity as all the residents of a major city like Pittsburgh use in a year. Which is why the tech sector is waking up to the fact that nuclear may be their best option. Bill Gates has invested $1 billion into a new nuclear facility in Wyoming. OpenAI CEO Sam Altman has backed not one but two nuclear startups. Microsoft plans on restarting a nuclear power plant in Pennsylvania that they've christened the Crane Clean Energy Center, though you might know it better by its original name, Three Mile Island. That's right, times have changed so much that they're reactivating the site of the worst nuclear disaster in American history. Although if you watched that other video, you'd know that that disaster didn't kill anyone, or injure anyone, or make anyone sick. So when it comes to safety risks, Three Mile Island ranks somewhere behind gas station sushi.
This is a bad idea.
But nuclear's newfound appeal isn't just about how much we need new plants. It's also about how much we need to keep the existing ones open. Here's why. Nuclear is a great source of what's called baseload power, which, put as simply as possible, means power we can rely on all the time. That's by contrast to things like wind and solar, which can only give you energy when the wind is blowing or the sun is shining. And because those renewable sources can't pick up the slack, there's a pretty clear pattern every time a nuclear plant shuts down. People tout it as an environmental victory, and then discover it means they're actually going to have to use more fossil fuels. When Japan backed off of nuclear power after the 2011 crisis at the Fukushima plant, another disaster in which no one died or got sick from radiation, it had to admit that its carbon emissions, which were previously projected to decrease by 6% by 2020, were actually going to increase by 3%. After New York shuttered its Indian Point nuclear facility in the early 2020s, it was estimated that the state ended up emitting over 4 million tons of carbon a year more than it would have if the plant had remained open. So, if nuclear is reliable, safe, environmentally friendly, and now even kind of popular, we must be getting ready to build a ton of it, right? Yes. If by us you mean everybody who's not us. Around the world, there are about 70 nuclear reactors under construction, with about 100 more planned. India is currently building 6. China is building 32. America? Yeah, that number is 0. Why? Well, there are a lot of reasons, but a big one is that the costs of building a nuclear power plant and the time it takes to build one are steadily increasing, largely because of increasingly complicated regulations. In the late 60s, it took about 4 years to build a nuclear plant. America's newest one, which just recently came online in Georgia, took 15. And relative to those 60s plants, today's cost at least 6 times more. Now, you could understand this a little more if all those old nuclear plants had been dangerous or unreliable, but we have pretty good evidence that they were built to last. And that evidence is that we're still using them. The average age of a nuclear power reactor in the US is 42 years. Bottom line, we've got some choices to make. If America continues to leave nuclear on the sidelines, we're setting aside virtually the only tool we have to simultaneously provide abundant energy and cut carbon emissions. And there are already signs that we might get left behind as a result. It's estimated that China will have more nuclear power than either the US or the EU within just 5 years. But that outcome isn't inevitable, because all the signs point to the fact that the American people are starting to get a better understanding of what is and isn't risky. And as a result, we're not afraid of nuclear power anymore. Gas station sushi, though, still terrified.